Hello students, good morning to all. So today we will start a new chapter, fractions and decimals. And today we will study about all the key terms which is involved in this chapter, fractions and decimals. And also we will solve the exercise questions of self-practice today. Now see fraction, what is the fraction? So any number which can be expressed in the form of p by q, any number which can be expressed. What is fraction? What is fraction? Fraction is any number which can be expressed, any number which can be expressed in the form of p by q. Any number which can be expressed in the form of p by q. P by q, where q is not equal to 0, means that denominator, means fraction contains two parts. The upper part p is called the numerator, and the lower part is q is called the denominator, and the denominator should not be 0. We cannot put the denominator of a fraction 0, because if the denominator will be 0, so the number will be undefined. So we, in any condition, this q should not be 0. Okay, so for any number which can be expressed in the form of p by q, where q is not equal to 0, is called fraction, is called fraction. Example we can take. Example 3 by 7. You can see here the p numerator is 3 and 7 is denominator. Example 3 by 7, 2 by 11, 14 by 6, and so on. All these are the fractions. Okay, so any number which can be expressed in the form of p by q, where q is not equal to 0, is called a fraction. We can also write 3 by 1. This is also a fraction. Denominator can be 1. We can write in 3 as 3 by 1. Any natural number we can write in the form of p by q, in the form of fraction. 3 we can write as 3 by 1. 5 we can write as 5 by 1. Okay, now kinds of fraction or equivalent fraction. Second term is the equivalent fraction. Equivalent fraction. So what is the equivalent fraction? Multiple of a given fraction. Any fraction is given, suppose p by q is a fraction. So if you find its multiple, means example you can take, suppose p by q is a fraction, so what will be its equivalent? Means value should be the same. So equivalent fraction is found by multiplying the same number, in the numerator and denominator of the fraction. So equivalent fraction of p can be find as p into 2 multiplied by q into 2. See here, a fraction contains numerator and denominator. Now the numerator and denominator, in both we multiply the same number by 2. So here we get the word multiple. So the value of this fraction is the equivalent fraction of p by q. To find the second, third equivalent fraction, we can multiply p by q by 3. So we get the second equivalent. This is the first equivalent, this is the second equivalent fraction. Now we can take the example. Now, we can also get the equivalent fraction by dividing the fraction, by dividing the numerator and denominator of the fraction by a certain number. We can divide this p and q also. Another equivalent fraction you can take, p by q, in both we divide by same number. Suppose divided by 4, we are also divided by 4. So if the same number you divide, the numerator and denominator of a fraction, then also you get the equivalent fraction. Now we take here some example and how we find the equivalent fraction of a given fraction. Now see, suppose you need to find the equivalent fraction of 3 by 5. This is 3 by 5 and we have to find its equivalent fraction. How many? Here we are going to find 2 equivalent fraction of this 3 by 5. So first equivalent fraction of the 3 by 5 will be what? We multiply by 2 in both the numerator and denominator. So here in the numerator also we multiply by 2 and in the denominator also we multiply by 2. So what you are going to get the first equivalent fraction? 3 2s are 6 and 5 2s are 10. So 6 by 10 is the equivalent fraction of this 3 by 5. If you want to find another equivalent fraction of 3 by 5, so next time you can multiply by 3. So see in the numerator and denominator of the equivalent of this fraction 3 by 5, this time you multiply by 3. You will get the second equivalent fraction. So what is the second equivalent? 3 3s are 9. And 5 3 is 15. So here by multiplying a certain number with the numerator and denominator of the fraction, we get its equivalent. Now another example we take, how we get the equivalent fraction by dividing. That is called the sum multiple. If you divide the fraction, the result what you get, that is called the sum multiple. And this is the multiple. If you are multiplying with a certain number in the numerator and denominator of the fraction, you get its multiple. So this 6 by 10 is the multiple of 3 by 5. How many times? 2 times. 9 by 15 is the multiple of 3 by 5. Now another fraction we take and then we find its equivalent by dividing. Suppose we here we are going to take 16 by, here we are going to take 16 by 25. 16 by 25. So we take the other number, it will be easy to find. 16 by 24. 16 by 24 one fraction we taken and we want to find its equivalent. So take 16 by 24 and divide both by a certain number. So here we are going to divide both the fraction by 2. Both the denominator of the fraction 16 by 24 we divide by 2. So when you divide 16 by 2, what you get the quotient? 2 8 plus 16. So quotient will be 8. And here when you divide 24 by 2, you will get the quotient 12. 2 12 is 24. So 8 by 12 is the equivalent fraction of 16 by 24. And also you can say 8 by 12 is the sum multiple of 16 by 24. Sum multiple will be always less because we are dividing the given fraction with a certain number. Okay, if the question will be asked, find the equivalent fraction of the given fraction. So you find the equivalent fraction by multiplying the certain number in the numerator and denominator of the given fraction. So whatever the product result you get, that will be the equivalent fraction. Okay, now we move to the kinds of fraction. Next is the kinds of fraction. So on the basis of the denominator, fractions is of two type. On the basis of denominator. On the basis of denominator. Fractions are of two types. One is, first is like fraction. And second is unlike fraction. So on the basis of denominator, so here we compare, so many fractions are given, so we compare the denominator of the fractions and on the basis of that we classify that fraction into like and unlike. Now we will study each part in detail, what is like fraction, what is unlike fraction. So before I proceed, first of all I want to explain you about the numerator and denominator of the fraction. See, in a fraction P by Q. Here P is the numerator. P is the numerator. So fraction is numerator upon denominator. Fraction is the ratio of numerator and denominator. So P by Q, here P is the numerator and Q is the denominator. So the upper part is called the numerator and the lower part is called the denominator. Okay. So now we, in the fractions we compare this denominator lower part. In the fraction we have to compare this denominator and on that basis we will decide it is like or unlike. Now what are like fractions? The fractions having the same denominator. If many fractions are given and all the fractions having the same denominator, so all those fractions are called like fractions. So example you can take, what is like fraction? Fractions having fractions having same denominator are called, so fractions having same denominator are called like fractions. Example you can see, two by seven, three by seven, four by seven, five by seven, six by seven. See how many fractions I have written here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here I have written 5 fractions and you can see here that all these 5 fractions having the same denominator 7. Here all the fractions having the same denominator 7. See, 2 by 7, here is also 7. 3 by 7, here is also the denominator 7. 4 by 7, here is also the denominator 7. 5 by 7, 6 by 7. Here all the fractions having the same denominator. So such type of fractions are called like fractions. Now unlike fractions, if the denominators are different, denominators are not same, so that fractions are called unlike fractions. So what do you write in the unlike fractions? Fractions having different denominator are called unlike fraction. Now see what is unlike fraction. So fractions having different denominators. So fractions having different Fractions having different denominators are called unlike fractions. Okay, so fractions having different denominators are called unlike fractions. Example you can see, 2 by 3, 3 by 7, 4 4 by 9, 5 by 11. Here you can see all these fractions have a different denominator. All these fractions have a different denominator. First fraction 2 by 3 has denominator 3. Second fraction 3 by 7 having the denominator 7. In 4 by 9 denominator is 9. In 5 by 11 denominator is 11. And all the denominators are different. So such type of fractions are called unlike fractions. Okay. Now we move on the basis of the numerator and denominator. On the basis of the value of the numerator and denominator, again the fraction is classified into two types: proper fraction and improper fraction. That also we see. Proper fraction and improper fraction. So proper fraction first you see, proper fraction. So on the basis of the numerator and denominator, now on the basis of numerator and denominator, on the basis of numerator and denominator. Okay. Fractions are also two types. First is proper fraction. So we will study what is the proper fraction. Proper fraction is that fraction in which the numerator is less than denominator. So fraction, a fraction in which numerator is less than denominator. So a fraction in which numerator is less than denominator, that is called the proper fraction. Example, you can see like 2 by 7. In this 2 by 7, 2 is the numerator and 7 is the denominator, and you can see 2 is less than 7. You can see the 2 is less than 7. So this is the proper fraction. Okay, this is the proper fraction. So example, what we have taken, 2 by 7. So 2 by 7, one example, other example you can quote here. 3 by 7, 3 is the less than 7, numerator is less than denominator, proper. 9 by 11, all these are the examples of proper fraction. You can see here 2 is less than 7, 3 is less than 7, 9 is less than 11. So fractions in which numerator is less than denominator is called proper fraction. Second, improper fraction. Second, improper fraction. Now, a fraction, a fraction in which numerator is greater than denominator. A fraction in which numerator is greater than denominator, that is called the improper fraction. Example, you can see that is 7 by 2. Now you can see in this fraction 7 by 2, 7 is the numerator and 2 is the denominator, and 7 is greater than 2. That is the improper fraction. 7 by 2, 11 by 3, 14 by 7, these are the examples. In these three fractions, you can see in each fraction
numerator is more than denominator. 7 is greater than 2, 11 is greater than 3, 13 is greater than 7. So such type of fractions are called improper fractions. Now these improper fractions are converted into the proper fraction, that is called the mixed fractions. These improper fractions are converted into the mixed fraction. Okay, now we'll see how we convert the improper fraction into the mixed fraction. So mixed fraction, now we are going to discuss about the mixed fraction. Now in this mixed fraction, so a fraction like a p by q means a fraction which is written in this form, where a is the mixed number, a is called mixed number. This is called mixed number. And this p by q is the proper fraction. And this p by q is called the proper fraction. What is this called? Proper fraction. So a fraction which contains a mixed number and proper fraction is called a mixed fraction. Now we'll see how we convert the improper fraction into the mixed fraction. So in that case, suppose here we are going to take this example 7/2. How we convert this 7/2 into the mixed fraction? So here we divide the numerator by denominator. To convert the improper fraction into the mixed fraction, we divide the numerator of the improper fraction by its denominator. So we divide the 7 by its denominator 2. So 2 3 is 6. 7 minus 6, remainder is 1. So to convert here we are going to convert 7/2, which is the improper fraction, to the mixed fraction. So mixed number is the quotient. So what you get the quotient here by dividing the numerator with its denominator, we write 3 on the place of mixed number. So here we write 3 on the place of mixed number, and the remainder will be the numerator. Remainder is what here? 1. So remainder you write on the place of numerator, and the denominator will be the same, which is the divisor, 3 1/2. So what is the mixed fraction of 7/2? 3 1/2. Like this we are converting the mixed improper fraction to the mixed fraction. Okay, so we can do its reverse operation also. How we convert this mixed fraction into the improper? So for that we have to multiply the mixed number with the denominator. So multiply the mixed number, 3 multiply 2, and add the numerator upon denominator. Now see, 3 multiply 2 gives you what? 6 plus 1/2. Now 6 plus 1 gives you 7/2. Now we can do its reverse also. How we convert the mixed fraction into improper? Multiply the mixed number with the denominator and add the numerator. So 3 multiply 2 plus 1/2 gives you the improper fraction. Okay, so this is all for the today, students. So in the next class we will solve the questions of the exercise and practice 2A. So this is all for today. Thank you for your kind attention.